This is the last new portable cassette recorder you can buy in stores today. Or actually, this is one model before it. This is the RCA RP3503. And the current model is the 3504. And you can find it on the shelf at Walmart for about 20 bucks. It comes bundled with an AC adapter and an external microphone. And as you'll hear from my test recordings, using an external microphone is highly recommended because the built-in one does not pick up very well and picks up a lot of background noise. And this is a very small and light cassette recorder. It does come with a handle, but it's a very flimsy plastic handle. On the side, you get the DC 6-volt input, microphone and remote jacks, earphone jack, which is actually a stereo jack. So, unlike a lot of these cassette recorders, if you plug in stereo headphones, you'll hear it through both sides, not just the left side. There's the volume control. There's no tone control or anything like that. It does have a tape counter. And your typical push button controls. There is some metal in the mechanism, but not much. For example, this is all plastic here, but these parts are metal, at least. And the buttons have a very snappy feel to them. It's almost like a tactile kind of feel to them. And it can run on 4 AA batteries. And that's really about it. So now let's hear a test recording I made.
RCA RP3503 cassette recorder. The model that replaced this, the RP3504, is the last new portable cassette recorder you can buy in stores today. They sell them at Walmart for about 20 bucks, and it comes bundled with an AC adapter and an external microphone. I got this one for $2.99 at a thrift store, and it seems to be working. It's a very small and cheap and light cassette recorder, but we'll see how this sounds. Okay, that first recording came out rather quiet and noisy, so I'm speaking closer to the microphone now, less than 1 foot away, so we'll see how this sounds. The fact that the built-in microphone doesn't pick up very well may be the reason why RCA bundles these cassette recorders with an external microphone, and I'm using one right now. It's a generic no-name 500 ohm dynamic microphone. We'll see how it sounds now with the external microphone. Well, to my ears, that actually sounded pretty good, at least through the little built-in speaker. I'll see how it sounds through headphones. And considering that this is most definitely DC bias, I think it's doing pretty good. So, not bad for a cheap little plastic Chinese-made cassette recorder.
Now, obviously, this is not meant for recording music, but I wanted to try doing it anyway. So I used my little iPod here and an attenuation cable and this hokey-looking adapter to convert the iPod stereo output to a mono input, because although the headphone output is stereo, it combines the channels, the microphone input is not combining the left and right. It's only one channel, so you have to combine it externally. So, we'll see how that sounds.
Sometimes I feel like I am drunk behind the wheel.
or the beginning of.
And finally, here's how it sounds playing a pre-recorded cassette through the built-in speaker. Obviously, due to the small size, it's going to be very tinny sounding. Obviously only recommended for voice recording. It can record music okay, but it really is just meant for voice.